is a deciduous tree. These are in too bad shape to be of much use in identification. But that would be an elm. These don't grow too much bigger than this anymore since Dutch elm disease invaded the Ottawa area back in the 70s. Okay, so this is the same species of tree that I just misidentified as an elm. Got a chickadee coming in to check us out. But this is a white oak. And it's got one of the leaves off the ground underneath of it, and we were able to unfold a couple of them to tell that they were white oak. So the large palmate, dull-lobed leaf signifies it's a white oak. Now this tree, it's almost silvery gray at the top, gets browner as it comes down, and the bark gets coarser and coarser as it comes down. This is an ash, and this is one of the better woods for making self-bows in the eastern woodlands. Here we have a pair of mourning doves come in to check out what we're up to. We don't have any feed with us to entice them in a little closer. They're obviously not at all scared of us. Of course, no Eastern Woodlands tree identification video would be complete without the paper birch. This time of year, we could be tapping this to make spruce beer, spruce sap, spruce. Yes, let's tap the birch tree and get spruce sap out of it. We could be tapping it to get birch sap to make birch beer or birch syrup. And somehow, some way, that became a tongue twister. I don't know if we can get this to show up well here. This is, judging by the wood piled around it, a yellow poplar stump just covered in turkey tail mushroom. So here's more of that same large vine with some small stuff growing up right here. Now, this walking trail was at one time farmland, so I'm going to say this is not indigenous, but a wild offshoot from can't think of the name of these. My mom's best friend used to grow them in her garden, big purple flowers.